Hello everyone, my name is the Radman, and we are here for some Factorio. Now, we're starting off by fixing a little problem that I noticed with the iron mine, and that is there's one single stone source in it. And I almost mine a tree before I figure out there's a bunch of coal sitting on a conveyor belt to feed the burner mining drill with. Now, I've noticed a problem with the production of green science, and that is obviously iron. Now, the problem is we don't exactly have room to work around, like to expand our smelter right now. So I decided instead that today we're going to work on mainly military stuff, because I've done a little bit of messing around with the mods, and while I was playing in the world, obviously, to test the mods, I found a few glitches or problems that come up, and the problems are that if I don't get walls in within, like, I think the next 2 episodes worth of time, I start having issues with the biters getting into the base. So I decided that rather than waiting until the last minute, we're just going to set it up now. And we're doing a system that is just using the lakes as kind of a natural barrier. And we're eventually going to get it set up to actually use the ammo off of that ammo maker that's sitting up by steel production. But that takes quite a while, because first we actually have to put all the infrastructure in place, and I break my pickaxe before realizing I don't want to craft 10 of them. Anyway, then we give all those a little bit of fuel, and we decide to go up and get some more ammo, because I realize that some of them don't have enough. And there isn't really that much ammo in the first place, though, because the assembler is only one assembler. Ideally, to feed a lineup in an actively attacked base, I would usually have about probably 4 going. Seems like a good number. Because you need a constant supply of ammo if the attacks are big enough. Also, we do a little bit of getting rid of some iron. I decided to artificially help the production of green science by putting in 200 iron into each inserter, or each assembling machine, and we had a little mini attack there. And the reason that the turrets are getting damaged in every attack, by the way, is because there's spitters and biters. So that makes me wonder if I should take my machine gun and go try and attack the bases. But I'm not so sure, because I think one of the mods tweaks something about the biter AI. Which might be why they are both spawning right now, because I was pretty sure you had to have a higher evolution factor than before. But anyway, now we're actually setting up a new line of steam engines, because we don't actually have enough power right now. And, yeah, I decided that we better just add in more power as it is. Also, I do discover the reason that the steam engines can only run at half power. It's because they are running seawater. I had kind of thought of this before, but I didn't really say anything about it. But I'm pretty sure that the mod Entech Chemistry adds in seawater, and you have to use, I think it's electrolysis, which is a high-level research used in the production of the oil fractions. I believe that you have to get to that point before you can get pure water. Now, that wouldn't be such a big deal, except that it takes away half of the efficiency, and there I had to reposition everything because I accidentally got it off. And this is something weird that I've noticed. Even though there is no hot water in those boilers right now, it must just be like the water backflowing or something, because the steam engines are actually turning a little bit, which is really strange, because I was under the impression that even if you had the water network connected together like I have it, the water would have to be going into the boilers, like, at least almost fully boiled. But I guess not. Oh, anyway, now what we're doing, by the way, is we are actually fixing the coal problem, because as I was working on setting up the power, I noticed there was hardly any coal coming through, so We're going to get rid of all these outdated burner mining drills and replace them with proper electric drills, because there's no reason that we shouldn't. I mean, everything that we have right now is run by electricity except for the coal patch. And I was actually taking a look at how much is in the patches, and there's a ton in there. And as you can see, a few of the burner mining drills had been getting pretty close to finishing off the area they were sitting on. But I think on average, each of those panel or miners actually has under it about, it's between like 15 and 20,000 coal, so we shouldn't have fuel problems for quite a while. One thing that I'm thinking of doing, though, if the if I can't get the steam engines to go more than half power, I'm thinking we might switch over to solar the second that we unlock it, because I have a few mods installed that allow for things like compressed solar panels, so even though we would be under constant attack, we could still have a little tiny solar farm that would be able to produce as much electricity as the steam engines. Though I think that does use blue science, so that probably wouldn't work, because it'll take us a while to get oil going, particularly because all of the oil deposits are actually outside of the wall right now, which is something that I didn't think about when making the wall. Anyway, so now all we're doing is we're going through and rebalancing ammo, because some of the gun turrets were getting very close to running out. And by the time I go through and rebalance all the gun turrets, I actually almost completely run out of ammo. Actually, I think I do at one point. But anyway, we also upgrade these to steel electric furnaces, since I already took out the coal supply. There's no reason to make regular steel furnaces. But we need more iron, and that was pretty well the easiest way to do it. Now, they do take quite a while to craft, so I kind of just run around looking at stuff, and I don't actually notice it now, but copper is beginning to run down. And if you look at the alien, okay, they aren't there yet, but in one of the next attacks, the aliens actually get really, really close to that wall where I have that sentry gun, and they actually get by the sentry gun when they die, which shows me that the walls, the path is a little bit wider than I thought it was, so I'm going to have to end up putting better walls there. But anyway, I think we just unlocked the Crusher mod, which allows for very primitive ore doubling. I don't dare try and put it in place right now as much as I would like to. We have like 10,000 iron in those deposits, and there's honestly no reason not to just let it mine out like normal. Once we get a train system in place, though, we'll probably make a few crushers and have ore doubling and everything, just so that we get more life out of each of the bases that we build. Anyway, now we're actually experimenting around with the tree farm mod. So one of the recipes requires just water and this sapling thing that it adds in, which is one wood apiece, and it takes 10 of them, and it gives you 25 wood after an extremely long period of time. Now, this actually causes a problem, because I'm running around waiting for, I think, the pump, probably, to craft, and in the back of my mind, I was thinking, I hope that this mod will work, because it requires regular water, which, if all the water is seawater, I wasn't sure if it was going to work, and I think we should get to it soon. Right now I'm kind of running around. Oh, this is when I go get some wood, because I realize that I don't have enough wood to even make the starting recipe, so we go and grab enough to do it. And the reason I want to have the tree farm, by the way, is because since there is no, there aren't a lot of trees in the area that the base is in, I really don't want to have to go outside the base for wood, for anything. I actually have a few times during this episode where I had to go find just random wood lying somewhere just to make a power pole, because we don't have level 2 power poles yet. Which is strange, because usually when my factory is this big, I usually have level 2 power poles, but I've just, since there's so much new research in the game, I've just been kind of messing around with it. And there's a problem that I have with one of the mods that I have installed. It's actually a mod I made myself. And for some reason, it actually cancels out the recipe for electronic circuits, so they can't be auto-crafted. And that's why I sometimes bulk craft about like 100 electronic circuits at once, is because auto-crafting just doesn't work, and I don't really know why. Anyway, that also affects pipes, though, which is why I had to make each individual pipe before I could make the underground pipes. And we're just about to get to where I find out just how annoying it is to have mods that change, like, water. Because that actually doesn't accept it. And I did a little testing off-camera, and it doesn't accept seawater, so I'm probably just going to remove the mod that adds in seawater, which is N-Tech Chemistry. In fact, I think we're going to look at one of its researches. There's some N-Tech Chemistry. And basically, all it does is make the oil processing more realistic. But in doing so, it adds seawater. And I'm pretty sure it changes all water to seawater. So if you have mods that require water, you're out of luck. So I decided just to disable it because I didn't want to mess around trying to fix it, because I just don't have time. And I do look at these other two ponds to see if maybe it's just the body of water I was by is big enough to be considered a lake, but no, it isn't. That's like everything. Anyway, let's see. And this is after I removed the mod, so I believe we go and check on the tree farm and find that it is working. Or it would be if I had given it its saplings that it requires. So see, we got water flowing, except it didn't auto-update. And then I realized that water, for some reason, won't enter most things until you put in everything. Now, I actually get really confused here, because I expect this to be like an assembly machine speed. So by the time I set up this little auto-feeder, which what it'll do is every time... It'll basically make it so that unless that wooden chest is full of wood, that plant will be running and producing wood. Which, one idea that I had is, what I could do is after I clear out the main coal deposit, I could just have a huge, backlog of coal to keep. And, then I could just, use wood from those farms to power it, but the good recipes get a little more complex. And now we're finally actually setting up the auto-feeding system for the turrets, because I realized that I really don't like running around refueling them. And I think, yeah, we actually had the stinking biters somehow blow up one of the turrets, though I wasn't in the area, so I'm not sure how they did it. I'm guessing what happened, though, is since it's one of the ones on the front lines, I'm guessing it just ran out and... I didn't notice that it had run out before they destroyed it. But it does make me kind of wonder if that's the case, since it was destroyed, yet the other turrets in the area didn't shoot down whatever had destroyed it before it was destroyed. So, I don't know, they might have just been taking chunks out of its health long enough. And we actually have to do a little bit of workarounds with the ammo belt, because it goes, like, right in the middle of the copper deposit. And this is actually where I run out of, power poles. So, right after this one, I run out of power poles, and I'm like, oh, crap, I need wood. So I go up to my thing, and I'm like, oh, it has, like, I think it takes it, 2 or 3 minutes to do one cycle. And I think that is in 3x speed, which, by the way, that's the time scale that I'm doing on this, because yeah, that means if I record an hour, it comes out to an even 20 minutes of video for you guys. Anyway, so we go and we collect some trees, and I was zoomed out so that I could tell if any biters came running at me. And if you actually look if you would have looked, you would have seen that there are actually not a lot of trees, besides the ones that I harvested. So, yeah, it's... The wood situation is getting a little bit dire at this point. It's like, I need it for power poles, But I forgot what I was gonna say, sorry. Let's see. Oh, finally we get enough to actually make more power poles. And, in a little bit, I actually run into a little bit of trouble when I decide that I'm going to craft green science packs myself, because I don't like the speed that science is going. And, I actually clog up my inventory for so long that I don't end up getting much done, because they take so many components to make green science packs do. So I think next episode, or the episode after, probably actually when we get this wall done, because I think this is going to be the top priority for until it's finished. We're probably going to, after it is finished, start working on revamping green science, because it's got more than enough assemblers to feed the amount of science labs that I have there, but it does not have enough throughput of just the materials that it needs, which is annoying, because when I set up the system, I thought it would scale pretty well, but obviously that didn't happen. I think my main problem is just I need more of the end assemblers. And anyway, here we go. We're actually finally getting to extending the wall upward, because the way I figure it is that turret on the very end that I kind of left out in the open and kind of forgot about, I figure that if they do destroy it, they will have to single file around the lake. And next episode I'll probably fill that in with a wall just in case, because at the time it seemed like a good idea to start the wall there. But I've now actually been thinking about it and I realized it might have been better to go farther along the coal deposit, but I do have a trick up my sleeve that I'm hoping to use, and it's the terraforming mod. Now, the terraforming mod, what it adds in that I love, is it lets you dig moats, and that's one thing that I want to do, is I want to dig moats that'll direct all the biters into one, like, funnel, where I can just eviscerate them. Because where the biters drop those small alien artifacts, I probably could if I set up the system to never be like destructible and be able to weather any attack. I probably could get it to the point where it's making me an alien artifact like every minute or so if the attacks are big enough. But that all remains to be seen. So I actually almost die here. Because I was trying to refuel that turret, and I didn't see its health, because I couldn't see it through the walls. And yeah, I had to end up retreating into the steam engine column just to not die. But luckily we did have that second line of turrets, or else I probably would have died, because if you are in the area, the spitters and biters will prioritize you over anything else. Which is a little bit scary, because it's like, if you run out of ammo, and you don't have a turret around, you basically have to hope that you can run slightly faster than a biter to the nearest turret. Sorry, my voice is getting a little dry. My throat is getting a little dry, not my voice. Wow, that was amazing. Anyway, we actually start setting up this second ammo assembly line, which I forgot to mention. But we don't actually have enough belts to hook it up, which really annoys me, because it's because I'm trying to craft green science, which, in hindsight, what I really should have done is just crafted a whole bunch of belts. I think I needed to craft more inserters and power poles, too. So what I should have done was just crafted a bunch of those, and then after that got done, I should have started crafting the sciences, but it's okay because I end up just canceling them, which allows all the power poles and stuff that I had queued up to go. So now our second wall, or part of the second wall, is actually up and running. And I guess the big debate now is how far should I take it up? Because I'm not sure if I want to have the wall be a level with the steam engines or higher. But now, actually, what we're doing is we're going around and repairing everything that's damaged, including all the walls. And we actually get attacked while I'm doing that. But luckily, the turret has ammo, so it kills the biters. Anyway, thank you for watching.